I'm going to be doing my intramuscular injection. We are going to be doing this drill. So I'm going to perform hand hygiene. I'm going to come to my Pyxis. This drill is on here. It's also known as hydroxine, and they have that in D3 right here. So I'm going to do my triple check, hydroxine, Mistral, which is hydroxine. The bottle's labeled 100 milligrams is in 2 ml, but we are only ordered to give 50 milligrams. So I'm going to only be injecting 1 ml today. So the next thing we can do now is clean the top for 10 seconds. Okay, and then we want to make sure we have the proper syringe. This is a 3 milliliter syringe. It's a large needle for the intramuscular injection. Okay, we're going to want to measure up 1 ml, which is right here. Okay, I'm going to put this back in D3. And we're now going to go to the patient's room. So, knock knock. Hi, Mr. Brown. My name is Stephanie. I'm going to be your nurse today. We're going to be doing an intramuscular injection and hygiene. I heard you were complaining of nausea, so this will relieve the nausea for you. Can you say your name and date of birth? Okay. That matches what you have here on the bracelet, and it matches what we have here on the MAR. And with intramuscular injections, you can give it either 3 fingers from the acromion process, but we usually don't do that there in the deltoid for elderly patients. So another place you can go to is the vastus lateralis, or what we're going to do today, which is going to be here. I'm going to place my hand on the side of the hip. I'm going to face my thumb towards the groin and my index finger towards the spine. And you want to give it right in between the 2 fingers here. So that's where we're going to give it. Okay. We're going to provide some privacy. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is go ahead and clean the area for 10 seconds. Okay, and we want to use a Z-trap method, which means you kind of pull it back as you inject it. Okay, so we're going to pull back, go in a 90-degree angle. Okay, here we go, Mr. Brown. Inject it slowly. Also, first aspirate. Make sure you didn't hit a blood vessel or anything or get any blood in there. And inject it slowly. Okay. Put the safety on. Cut the sharps. Okay. Go ahead and document that we gave that at 344, so 1544 in his ventral gluteal area. On the right side. Go ahead and sign off on that. Okay, Mr. Brown, that should help alleviate your nausea within the next 20 to 30 minutes or so. If you need anything, here's your call light. I'm going to put your bed in the lowest position with your handrails up. Two nursing diagnoses would be that he would have impaired his skin integrity because we pierced the skin, and also he would also be at risk for infection because we did pierce the skin, so there's always that chance that bacteria can get in there and cause an infection, so we need to watch for that. But once that is done and the patient's comfortable and everything, we're good to go.